Hello everyone, it is a pleasure for me to be able to present at ACNS this year, even though unfortunately I cannot meet you all in person. Hopefully we will be able to meet at a later time. So my name is Lilia Kraleva and I will present to you our paper Rotational Cryptanalysis on MAC algorithm Chasqui, which is a joint work with Tomer Ashour and Vincent Riemann. We focused our attention on the MAC algorithm Chasqui, which is a standard from last year. Its design is dedicated to 32-bit microcontrollers such as small chips used for various applications from home devices such as ovens, refrigerators and more, to life-important applications such as providing critical functions for medical devices, vehicles and robots. Chasqui is fast, small and provably secure. We have two main contributions in this work. First, we use rotational cryptanalysis to perform distinguishing, tag forgery and key recovery attacks on round-reduced versions and on the full 12 rounds of the MAC algorithm Chasqui. For example, for the full 12 rounds of the algorithm, we can present a valid pair of a message and attack with probability 2 to the minus 86 for a related key being the wordwise rotation of the initial key. Additionally, we give a generalization of some well-known results on Markov ciphers in order to include the rotational relation into them. We extend the definition of a difference between two plaintext to a relation between two plaintext in order to accommodate the rotational relation within it. Then, by using relation between plaintext, we redefine Markov cipher and the hypothesis of stochastic equivalence. In this presentation, we will concentrate on the attacks of Chasqui. Details about our second contribution can be found in the paper. My presentation will go as follows. First, I will present to you the algorithm of Chasqui. Then, I will show the idea of rotational cryptanalysis and how it is applied, followed by our rotational attacks on Chasqui. I will conclude my presentation with some final remarks. Chasqui has been proposed in 2014 and is ISO standard since last year. Its design is small and fast. In this slide, you can see some numbers for comparison with AS. In addition, due to the Even-Mansur structure, Chasqui is provably secure and claimed to be resistant to many cryptanalysis techniques like differential, truncated differential, and linear attacks. Here are presented the mode of operation of Chasqui and one round of its permutation. You can see that the key is introduced only in the beginning and in the end of the algorithm, which is the Even-Mansur structure. After each block of plain text is added to the state, the permutation is applied. At the end, depending whether the last block is full or not, different key, K1 or K2, derived from the initial one is added. The permutation of Chasqui is shown at the right and consists only of XOR, rotation and modular addition operations. The keys K1 and K2 are derived from K by polynomial multiplication with X, correspondingly with x squared over the finite field f2 to the 128. For k1, this multiplication means that k is shifted with one position to the left if the first bit, which is the leftmost bit, is equal to 0, or shifted and then xored with a constant if the first bit is 1. For this generating polynomial, the constant is 135 in decimal. If the bit is 0, then K1 can be simply considered as a rotation of K. For K2, the same operation is valid and applied twice. The state of Chasqui is 128 bits, divided into 4 32-bit words. The tag can take any size up to 128 bits. The authors claim that 8 rounds of the permutation are enough to ensure security, but set 12 rounds to be used. Before explaining the rotational technique, I'll first introduce some terminology. We call a rotational amount R the number of bits that are shifted and rotated. A pair of two inputs is called rotational if one is a rotation of the other with some fixed rotational amount. And finally, rotational probability refers to the probability of having the corresponding outputs after some operations of a rotational pair being also rotational. Rotational cryptanalysis is a probabilistic attack usually applied to RX ciphers. It is easy to see that the rotational property holds for any bitwise operation. The attack relies on the fact that the rotational probability after XOR or rotation is 1, while, as it can be seen on the slide, this is not the case for modular addition. Therefore, the rotational probability after several such operations will depend only on the modular additions. So how does the attack work? The basic idea is to take a known input-output pair, then a new pair derived by rotating both the input and the output will be accepted as valid with some probability depending on the rotational property. Note that in most schemes we divide the state into equal blocks or also code words and apply operations on them separately. Then, as a rotation to the input, we consider a word-wise rotation, meaning that every word is rotated individually. We denote this with an arrow on top. In a paper by Kovratovich et al. From 2015, the authors introduced chained modular additions, meaning that the output of one addition is input to another. They show that the more additions are connected in a chain, the smaller the rotational probability is. A rotation or an XOR bring enough entropy into the state and break the chain. To illustrate the chain of modular additions, let us take a look at the following two figures. Both of them have the same number of modular additions and operations. In the left one, there is a rotation in the left branch between the two additions, while in the right figure, this rotation is moved, so the two modular additions form a chain. Even though the two figures have the same number of additions, their rotational probabilities are different. 2 to the minus 2.8 for the singular additions and 2 to the minus 3.6 for the chained additions. First, it was considered that the probability depends only on the number of additions and not on their positions. Additions were considered to form a Markov chain, meaning that the output of the ith addition does not depend on the previous additions. This proves to be false since the first bit is biased to 1. Hence, the total rotational probability was calculated by multiplying the probabilities of all modular additions. For q additions, the rotational probability would be p to the power q, where p is the probability of a single modular addition. In the same paper by Kovratovich et al., the authors prove the following lemma for calculating the rotational probability of chained modular additions, named as lemma 2 in their paper. The formula considers the number of additions in a chain, the rotational amount, and the size of the words. The difference in the probabilities calculated with the two formulas is quite big when more additions are involved. In this table, you can see the probabilities for a fixed rotational amount 1 and different number of chained additions. The numbers suggest that the more chained additions lead to better security against rotational cryptanalysis. Our attack considers one full block of message M, and therefore the key added at the end is K1. Then there is only one permutation, and the final Chasqui function is as shown here. We need to first evaluate the rotational probability of a single permutation p and then the total rotational probability of the whole function. In order to evaluate the rotational probability of p, we need to determine the number of modular additions and their positions. In the figure is shown one round of the permutation. We can see that there is one chain of two additions, colored in blue, and two single additions in the round. Further, the second modular addition in the third subblock form a chain of two additions when continued to the next round, which is colored in red. Hence, with each additional round, we have two more chains. In this table, we can see how many single and chained additions we have for any number of rounds until 12. Additionally, the corresponding rotational probability is noted, calculated with lemma 2, which is the new formula, and the probability calculated experimentally up to 5 rounds because of the data complexity. Next, we need to evaluate the final rotational probability of the big P. By simply rotating the message, we see that we cannot have a rotational pair of the outputs. Hence, we have to consider also related keys. We need not only the worldwide rotation of M, but also of K and K1, since the XOR preserves the rotational property. Here, K1 is the key derived from K, and K1 prime is derived from the rotation of K. So, in order to have a rotational pair, we need K to be such that the key obtained from the rotation of K is equal to the rotation of K1. Let us take a key K and its corresponding K1. The star in this notation represents any bundle of 30 bits that we are not interested in, and the letters represent a single bit. Note that when the first bit of K is 0, then K1 is simply a state rotation of K. If A equals 1, then K1 will not be a rotation of K, but a rotation and XOR with 135 in decimal. Therefore, we set A to be 0. We apply the same reasoning for the worldwide rotated K and its corresponding K1 prime. So we also fix the first bit B to be 0. As I mentioned before, we want K1 prime to be equal to the rotated K1. Therefore, A equals F, F equals K, and so on. This means that all letters that are involved in this notation should be equal and set to 0. This gives us a weak key class of size 2 to the 120, where the first two bits of every word of the key are set to 0. We can now present our attack scenarios. We propose a straightforward tag forgery attack in the multi-user scenario as follows. First, we identify two users using related keys. One way of identifying such users is by querying each of the n users with the same message m and then store the corresponding tags. By doing the same thing, but this time with the worldwide rotation of the first message, we can look for a collision between the stored tags and the new tags. When two such tags collide, the corresponding users have related keys. After the users are identified, we collect ciphertext tag pairs from one user. Then simply rotate the pair and send the new one for verification. As a result, from user with some key K, we can generate a valid tag for some message M rotated under the related key K rotated with complexity of the attack 2 to the 86 for 12 rounds, under the assumption that we are in the weak key class. Further, we can use this property as a distinguisher and extend it to a key recovery attack. we can distinguish whether we are in the weak key class. In this setting, we can use the authentication oracles for the related keys K and K rotated. The properties of ChasKey allow us to tag 2 to the 48 messages under the same key, therefore we will take a set of that many messages. First, we send each of them to the oracle for K and their word-wise rotations to the oracle for K rotated, and we store the given tags. If the key K belongs to our weak key class of 2 to the 120 keys, we expect the number of colliding tags to be 2 to the 48 times P, where P is the rotational probability. For example, for 6 rounds of ChasKey, the probability P is 2 to the minus 42, and we expect 64 messages for which this happens. For more rounds of the permutation, the success probability of the tag will be smaller. Once we have distinguished the weak key class, we know 8 bits of the key. Then we can recover the full key by guessing the rest of the bits, hence having complexity of 2 to the 120. A summary of our attacks is shown in the following table. You can see the type of the attack with its data complexity and the number of rounds that we can attack. In conclusion, I'll say that our attacks are theoretical and in the weak key-related key scenario, so they are not a real threat to the security of ChasKey. Nevertheless, we show results on the full 12 rounds of the algorithm and improve the understanding of the cryptanalysis resistance of the cipher. This would be the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention, and if you have any questions, you can also ask them by email.